This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The United States has formal diplomatic relations with most nations except for Bhutan, Iran, North Korea, Syria, and Taiwan. The United States federal statutes relating to foreign relations can be found in Title 22 of the United States Code Diplomatic Relations between World States and the United States. 4 Europe 5 Africa 51 North Africa 52 Sub-Saharan Africa 6 countries with visa services suspended 7 countries with no U.S. Embassy 8 See also 9 references 10 external links Oceania country formal relations began notes. Commonwealth of Nations It has, however, strengthened its relationship with the United States since 1942, as Britain's influence in Asia declined, to establish its current position as a staunch American ally at the governmental level. United States-Australia relations are formalized by the ANZUS Treaty and the Australia-United States Free Trade Agreement, citation needed. Concurrently accredited to Kiribati and make periodic visits the U.S. Peace Corps maintained a program in Kiribati from 1974 to 2008. This security relationship can be changed or terminated by mutual agreement The compact that binds the U.S. and the FSM is the same one that binds the United States to the Marshall Islands and to Palau. Islands both cooperate within regional organizations in the Pacific, and the United States has an embassy at Port Moresby. America's country formal relations began notes. See Belize-United States relations. International issues The United States has increasingly regarded Brazil as a significant power, especially in its role as a stabilizing force and skillful interlocutor in Latin America as a significant political and economic power. Brazil has traditionally preferred to cooperate with the United States on specific issues rather than seeking to develop an all-encompassing, privileged relationship with the United States. 1824 See Chile-United States relations Relations between Chile and the United States have been better in the period 1988-2008 than any other time in history In the late 1980s and early 1990s, the United States government applauded the rebirth of democratic practices in Chile, despite having facilitated the 1973 Chilean coup d'état, the buildup to which included destabilizing the country's economy and politics regarded as one of the least corrupt and most vibrant democracies in South America, with a healthy economy, Chile is noted as being a valuable ally of the United States in the Southern Hemisphere. A prime example of cooperation includes the landmark 2003 Chile-United States Free Trade Agreement. Affairs through the implementation of policies concerned with the above issues. Some critics of current U.S. policies in Colombia, such as law professor John Barry, consider that U.S. influences have catalyzed internal conflicts and substantially expanded the scope and nature of human rights abuses in Colombia. Supporters, such as Under Secretary of State Mark Grossman, consider that the U.S. has promoted respect for human rights and the rule of law in Colombia, in addition to the fight against drugs and terrorism. Nicaragua and the United States have had diplomatic relations since 1824 between 1912-1933. The United States occupied Nicaragua See United States occupation of Nicaragua Following the United States occupation of Nicaragua, in 1933 the Somoza family political dynasty came to power, and would rule Nicaragua until their ouster on July 19, 1979 During the Nicaraguan Revolution the era of Somoza family rule was characterized by rising inequality and political corruption, strong U.S. support for the government and its military, as well as a reliance on U.S.-based multinational corporations. This led to international condemnation of the regime and in 1977 the Carter administration in the U.S. cut off aid to the Somoza regime due to its human rights violations Then during the Reagan administration the diplomatic relations escalated during the Iran-Contra affair and the United States embargo against Nicaragua Then in 1990 after Violeta Chamorro won the Nicaraguan general election, 1990 The diplomatic relations began to improve greatly The United States has promoted national reconciliation, encouraging Nicaraguans to resolve their problems through dialogue and compromise In the summer 2003 Nicaragua sent around 370 soldiers to the Iraq War as part of the U.S. coalition of countries that were engaging in war in this country Immediately after April 2004 these troops were withdrawn by President Enrique Bolaños Although President Daniel Ortega has been publicly critical of U.S. policies, the United States and Nicaragua have normal diplomatic relations. Exchange ideas on a variety of economic topics. In March 2003, the JCTI identified six areas of concentration until the eventual signing of the Free Trade Area of the Americas FTAA: customs issues, intellectual property protection, investment, labor, environment, and trade in goods. In late 2004, Uruguay and the U.S. signed an Open Skies Agreement, which was ratified in May 2006. In November 2005, they signed a bilateral investment treaty BIT, which entered into force on November 1, 2006. A Trade and Investment Framework Agreement TIFA was signed in January 2007. More than 80 U.S.-owned companies operate in Uruguay, and many more market U.S. goods and services. Barack Obama, including the re-establishment of diplomatic relations in June 2009. Caribbean country formal relations began. Notes. 1974 – See Grenada-United States relations. 1962 – See Trinidad and Tobago-United States relations. Asia-East Asia country formal relations began. Notes. Since 1945, U.S.-Japan relations have improved greatly. One China policy. The U.S. continued to provide Taiwan with military aid after 1979, and continued informal relations through the American Institute in Taiwan. Southeast Asia country formal relations began. Notes. The political relationship between the United States and Burma worsened after the 1988 military coup and violent suppression of pro-democracy demonstrations. Subsequent repression, including the brutal crackdown on peaceful protesters in September 2007, further strained the relationship after 2010 elections and reform started by President Thein Sein and subsequent endorsement of reforms by leader of National League for Democracy NLD Aung San Suu Kyi and participation in April 2012 by-elections to parliament has led to thawing of relationship with United States President Barack Obama visiting Burma. A first by a United States president. See Laos-United States relations. That take place once a year to boost relations between the two countries. The U.S. military also conduct humanitarian and aid missions in the Philippines. The Philippines is one out of two major U.S. allies in Southeast Asia. However, relations between the United States and the Philippines began to deteriorate in 2016, under President Rodrigo Duterte, wanting to form an alliance with China and Russia and separating the country from all connections and ties with the United States, both economically and socially. Clinton's normalization announcement. In August 1995, both nations upgraded their liaison offices opened during January 1995 to embassy status as diplomatic ties between the nations grew. The United States opened a consulate general in Ho Chi Minh City, and Vietnam opened a consulate in San Francisco. Central Asia country formal relations began. Notes. 1991 – See Turkmenistan-United States relations. The U.S. Embassy, USAID, and the Peace Corps are located in Ashgabat, Turkmenistan. The United States and Turkmenistan continue to disagree about the country's path toward democratic and economic reform. The United States has publicly advocated industrial privatization, market liberalization, and fiscal reform, as well as legal and regulatory reforms to open up the economy to foreign trade and investment, as the best way to achieve prosperity and true independence and sovereignty. Country formal relations began. Notes. Through its embassy in New Delhi, the U.S. has offered to resettle 60,000 of the 107,000 alleged Bhutanese refugees of Nepalese origin now living in seven UN refugee camps in southeastern Nepal. West Asia country formal relations began. Notes. 1946 – See United States-Yemen relations. Traditionally, United States-Yemen relations have been tepid, as the lack of strong military-to-military ties, commercial relations, and support of Yemeni President Ali Abdullah Saleh has hindered the development of strong bilateral ties during the early years of the George W. Bush administration. Relations improved under the rubric of the War on Terror, though Yemen's lack of policies toward wanted terrorists has stalled additional U.S. support. Europe country formal relations began. Notes. 1920, 1991 – See Armenia-United States relations. See Bosnia and Herzegovina-United States relations. See Estonia-United States relations. The United States was one of the first countries to recognize Kosovo. See Moldova-United States relations.